The Fox and the Little Red Hen. Once upon a time, a little red hen lived all by herself in a little hen house on the edge of a wood. It was a neat, cozy home, and the little red hen was very happy there. She would spend her mornings cleaning and tidying, and once she had finished, she would go into the wood to search for food. On the other side of the wood lived a sly fox and his mother. Every day the fox would watch the little red hen pecking for grain, and his mouth would begin to water. One morning the little fox had an idea. "Mother," he said, "tonight we will have something delicious for dinner. I am going to catch the little red hen. You make a fire and set the water boiling in the pot. Then when I come home, we'll have a delicious meal." He picked up a big sack, which he threw over his shoulder, and then he set off across the wood in search of the little red hen. The little red hen, of course, had no idea about the fox's cunning plan. She had just finished a day's housework and was now busy pecking around on the ground amongst the trees, clucking happily to herself. She did not see the sly fox creep behind the trees and bushes and then make a dash for her hen house. She did not see him go through the door and then close it behind. Not long afterwards, the hen began to tire of pecking and she decided to go back inside and rest. She reached the pretty little house and went inside. She was just about to lock the door when she saw the fox. She clucked and flapped and flew up to the rafters as fast as she could. As soon as she calmed down, the little red hen shouted down to the crafty fox, who was still waiting patiently below. "You won't catch me now. I'm safe up here and I am not coming down. Give up and go home." "Ha!" laughed the fox. "I'll soon bring you down from there. Just you wait and see." The fox began to run round and round in circles, chasing his tail. Faster and faster he went, until the little red hen, who had been watching him nervously, started to grow dizzy. Her head began to spin, and she could no longer keep her balance on the narrow beam. She fell down and dropped straight into the fox's open sack. Immediately, the fox closed the sack, trapping the little red hen inside. Then he put the bag over his shoulder and started for home. A short while later, the fox began to feel a little tired. The heat from the sun was warm and carrying the hen was hard work. He decided to sit down under the shade of a large oak tree and have a little rest. It was not long before he fell asleep. The little red hen, hearing the fox's snores, decided that she must escape. She wasted no time and crept quickly out of the sack. Looking around her, she saw that there were several stones lying on the ground. Working as hard as she could, she rolled as many of them as possible into the sack and then tied it up. Then she scurried off as fast as she could go. She didn't stop until she was back at her little hen house with the door safely locked behind her. Soon the fox woke up from his nap and carried on with his journey. "This hen is heavy," he said to himself. "She'll make a good dinner." He licked his lips at the thought of the plump, tasty hen. When at last the fox arrived home, he called out to his mother. "Is the water boiling, mother?" "Yes, son," his mother replied. "Did you catch the little red hen?"
"I certainly did," answered the sly fox. "She's right here in this sack. She's very heavy, I can tell you. We'll have a good feast today, no doubt about that. When I say go, you lift the lid off the pot and then I'll drop the little red hen right into the boiling water."
So the mother fox listened as her son began. "Ready, steady, go!" he shouted. At that moment, the mother lifted the lid off the pot and the fox opened up the sack. The heavy stones tumbled one by one into the boiling hot water with a huge splash. And that was the end of the sly fox and his mother. But the little red hen lived happily ever after in her cozy hen house on the edge of the wood.